Hello everybody, this is Josh Bycer from GameWisdom.com. Apparently the game crashed the second I started the stream, so give me 1 minute to pull it back up. Come on Sega.
Sega.
There we go. While we're waiting for that to load up, welcome everyone, this is Josh Bycer from GameWisdom.com. This is going to be a stream or video for those of you watching this on YouTube of Sonic. It's still the Sonic 25th anniversary, so I figure I want to go through and attempt to play through all the classic Sonic games, or the ones I get my hands on for the PC. One second, I'm just loading back up Twitch. Hopefully it will actually be friendly and not break on me this time. Okay, we are good. Alright. So, previously we went through and played. Let me get my gamepad back. Went through and did Sonic 1 and got through with all the Chaos Emeralds. It's time for Sonic 2. And this is the one probably a lot more recognizable. The level design was enhanced as well as made a whole lot harder, including the new bonus 3D minigames. I'm pretty sure I did not beat this one as a child, so we'll see when I get redemption this time. I love it. See, we set up different things. Well, I don't know why you ever play without Sonic or play as one or the other like that, but we'll see. Alright, the graphics look a little bit better. More importantly, you now have the spin dash. That move, of course, was really neat in the first game and was added for all subsequent titles because you need some way of basically speeding up your momentum from a standing position. Especially considering that you have to get that momentum going in order to really make any action in the game. As before, we want to get our hands on 50 rings. And not get killed, of course, as well. Now, it's been a while since I played this. I'm trying to remember if we get the bone stage through the checkpoints or again through end of level play. But I suppose at the rate I'm going, we're going to find out pretty soon. Pretty sure you need the end of level, but nope. The checkpoints. Yes. The idea is we need to get the ring minimum for each part of the play. Just are having Tails come in real handy because he can also pick up those rings for you. The trick to beating this is you always want to go over the number of rings that you need. That way you'll have this buffer for the next section, as you can see. Now while it's easy right now, they're going to start adding in obstacles and ways to lose rings, like right there. You pretty much need to have both of them in order to get rings like in this kind of crazy pattern like that. Again, as long as we keep above the minimum, we are golden. Run out of rings. Oh, I'm sorry, you fail to get the number of rings you need, and you'll be booed out of the stage. Again, this was pretty ingenious for the time. There wasn't really anything else like this on the market. That should be more than enough for the Chaos Emerald. I mean, this is a game that also introduced Super Sonic. But we'll see. So having the mini self get put into the checkpoint, oh, we lost all of our rings, makes it easier to get them in a level, but it also adds a little bit more pressure to you, because the levels are now a lot harder. Stop. And see, we've lost all of our rings, as well as our lovely shield. That was horrible. Come on. Okay. Don't want to actually hit that until we have 50 rings. Oh! Pretty sure we're going to lose more. Can we do it? Oh, tails. No. Right now I'm trying to be extra fancy. And see me go for 2 emeralds in a single level. And if you had the lock on, you could actually have played with Knuckles back in the day. I think there's a mod for that with this version. Now we know there's only 7 rings, or 7 emeralds. It's not going to be easy getting them all. Sometimes you gotta be psychic to know where they're coming from, or have already played the stage before. Okay, that's 1. You'll also start seeing me doing jumps across really soon. And this is the other kind of a weakness of having Tails along for the ride. If he gets hit, all his rings are knocked out. So you want to try and keep it to Sonic whenever possible. The good news is, I got over. But just barely. But it was enough. And again, we want the best ending of the game. We need to have all the emeralds by the time we get to the final act. That should be it, yep. Once again, the earlier we get all the emeralds, the easier it's going to be for us in the long run. And some of the later zones in this game are very challenging. I should have just done that. Once again, we want to hit 50 and then find a checkpoint. You can never kill Tails, we'll just keep coming back. Should be something over here. Yep, there it is. Oh. Pretty sure I'm about to get hit here. Oh, good. Again, if you know what you're doing, you can get all the emeralds very quickly in this game. Gotta do tricks like this, jump down and deal with things in the air like that. See, it takes more time to jump, so it's easier to move. Again, we want to get as many as we can. And try to get that buffer. Tails. Over, but just barely. One, I think this is the last one. That was very close. You can see the margin for error gets less and less as we get more of the emeralds. That was horrible. And it's also telling that there's only two acts now. Well, that should be coming off. I think this path is going to shoot out. Yep. Love his face when you knock him out there. And we save the cuddly animals. I still hear this music from the zone, even to this day. Oh no, don't fall. This is another zone that really exemplifies Sonic's high speed. You're gonna see that in a whole lot of running you're gonna be doing. We'll get hit by that. And of course, avoiding those things whenever possible. Then we need to get as many rings as we can. that's enough. Now we just need the checkpoint. You get really paranoid when you're trying to secure the rings. Oh, we missed all the checkpoints? Damn. Again, depending on the path that you take through these levels, you may miss the checkpoints multiple times, and that's why you really want to get that buffer of getting early emeralds. Oh, damn. So we're gonna go the hard way. Yep. These accordion-like platforms are back. Once again, we are looking for our rings. There's a checkpoint, but obviously we are way, way away from that one. Oh, wait. No, stop. What the? What the hell is that? Oh, good. Alright, this will be emerald number 4. Oh, this used to drive me nuts, by the way, as a child. I got really frustrated doing these bonus levels. Oh, no, yo. Okay, good news is we got that. Ooh, that was really close. Jumping really comes into play. I have a feeling I may not get the ring this time. Baby. Ah. I believe we're about to get to some poison water sections now. Oh, Tails just drowned. Here comes the water. Yep, it's everybody's favorite. The water sections. I don't think I'm going to get enough rings for another attempt. Ooh. They really love to screw with the player, don't they?
Don't.
Well, I didn't have enough anyway. Get me out of there. We should be at the boss. Whoa. Start moving. Wow, that was lucky. At least Tails provides a second attack. That's a weird noise for an arrow, isn't it? Again, we want the rings. And to make it easier on myself, I may save scum before each special stage. Uh-oh. Again, we don't want to hit that just yet. Need six more rings. Stop. Damn. Oh wait. Maybe we can get back the upper way? No. Ah, yes. Wonderwar. I think we should be coming to another checkpoint. Oop. Where the hell did that come from? If you're not going for the emeralds, you can get through this very quickly. I think we're going to need those continues too. Oh boy. Okay. Well, that was a very low fall there. And there's still the checkpoint at the end of the level. Oh! No, no, no. Yeah, you can see how much the level designs really evolved between Sonic 1 and 2. Saw there was a checkpoint up there. Slow down. I'm sure we're going to be at the end of the level very shortly. Bounce on them. Mm-hmm. sometimes if you can angle the attack just right, you can hit him multiple times. Two or three more, I think, should be it. Not too bad. But we're behind in the Emerald count. Casino Night Zone. Probably one most people remember the most from Sonic 2. Here, but we're on the hunt for those emeralds. Enough for the checkpoint. Jeez. Nope. Yes, those dread bumpers from the bonus stage of Sonic 1 are back. There should be a secret here. Again, we still need to find the checkpoint. I don't think there we're gonna find one either, but we'll see if I can get lucky. Oh, that was not lucky. Okay, so we came here. I have a feeling the level's about over. Oh, good. Alright. Like I said, just to give us a chance of getting everything, we will do this to make life a little bit easier for us. Fell for it again. There should be a delay on this one. Yep. That was terrible. But I think we're still in a good position. It's important to build up that buffer in case Tails decides to screw you. Alright. That's how it's supposed to work. Okay, that's four. We need two more. I think. Is that another continue? The minigame from Sonic 3 is, I think, one of my favorites just because of... Oh my god, we almost got hit there. How insanely elaborate it is to play. Ooh. That means we are going the wrong way. Probably won't be able to use that one, though. But levels like Casino Night are one of the things that really made Sonic stand out from its competitors. You really just did not see anything like this during the classic era here. I'm trying to get into the slot machine. Because you can actually get rings that way. Whee! Oh, jeez. There we go. Never lucky. Whether in real life or in virtual, slot machines are just not my friends. Uh-oh. We'll get there eventually. We only have a 10-minute time limit. Bar, bar. There we go. I wonder if this game gave him the idea to do Sonic Spinball. Level should be coming to an end. There we go. We're still good on the ring. Oh, I'm sorry, on the emerald count. There's also another way you can cheese lives if you're good enough to get the jackpots. Or lucky, I should say. I just had a flashback. I just remember one of the more annoying zones is coming up in this game. I think it's like an oil zone, if I remember right. Uh-oh. No! Again, that's my luck in Vegas. Can hurt these guys. Alright, let's try one more time. Maybe we can get lucky. Or we'll get worse, let's see. Eh, 10 rings. It would be funny to show you what happens if you get the jackpot. But I don't know if we'll have that much luck. Especially if I can't get inside the machine. There we go. I think it's just random, too. And my luck at gambling continues. Alright. Screw it, let's get going. So if you're lucky, you can make a whole lot of rings that way. Or if you're like me, you just lose them all multiple times. Oh wait, that's a shield. Come on. At least that'll make it a little bit easier on us. Oh, oh, oh. Alright, I'm going to have to play the slot then. If we want to get enough for that. Let's get this so I can easily jump. Good. Perfect. Just what I needed. So this will be number 5? Sonic and his gambling problem, yep. And every game has some kind of like casino-based zone in it too. Okay. So this is number 5 of 6. It's gonna get crazier now. This is where, if you had two players, it would be a lot easier to do. Because you just literally can get all those rings. And this is why I'm starting to save scum for this specific part. Yeah. As I said, it gets very nasty. Oh, so they did add in the 7th Chaos Ring, or a Chaos Emerald, thank you, Ice Katsumi. If I remember right, this is where the bombs were, yep. Good thing we got enough rings, but I don't know if we'll have enough for the next section. The trick is you have to move fast enough to keep up with the rings, but not so fast enough that you're overshooting when they go off screen. Okay, good news, we got enough. There's still one more section. Oh boy. Thank you, Tails. Oh, that was horrible. No. I have a feeling I'm gonna have to restart. Yep. As I said, this is where things just get very tricky to do. And this first part really doesn't help you either, because it relies on two players. So you pretty much have to barely make it through this one, and then do incredibly well on section 2. Barely. It's when you get to that ring around, you have to go above the screen. That's where you really need to hit perfectly in order to have a chance. Oh no, yo. Whoa. I don't know if I'm gonna have enough though for this part. Should start going over. Oh, yeah, not gonna do it. Oh, damn. As I said, if you're trying to go for everything in this game, it is very tricky. It wouldn't, again, if I had a second player, this part is a lot easier. Okay, so the bombs are gonna start coming here. Oh, that was terrible. No. I missed that whole section there. Yeah, this minigame, this is why I didn't like it that much, because it basically relies on you having a second person. And if you don't, you just really get punished here. Okay. This is when the bombs show up. That was a lot better. Alright, that was much better. 120, 125. Let's see if this is enough. Ugh, damn. I don't think it's going to be, but we'll see. No. Oh, damn. I had it too, and I screwed up at the last second. For you folks watching live or record, you may want to go grab a drink now, because we'll see how long this actually takes. I think this is the most annoying one. If we can get through this, the final two are at least a little bit more doable. Okay. So I'm gonna come around here. Off by one, I think, from our last play. This one, they're gonna come above. Back over here. Alright, I'm off by five from the last one. Yeah, I know, it's Tails' fault. Okay, I'm gonna fall for that one. Now they're gonna come from above. Damn, I hate that one. Alright, so that's five. Five down, two to go. Is this the end of the level, too? Some of these, like, bonus sections are kind of crazy to figure out how you get to them. Yeah, let's screw that. Well, we might as well play into Sonic's gambling addiction here. This is probably a good public message about gambling, just make it impossible to get to the slots. There we go. This must be an alternate way. Sonic levels just love to throw in alternate routes. Come on. I don't know what's more annoying, the springs or the bumpers in this game. Okay, there we go. I have a feeling there's a checkpoint up ahead. The good news is we have enough for one more go. Alright, this is 6 of 7. Again, to make life easier on me. And you can't turn Tails off, because if you do, then you lose his ability to grab more rings. Tricking me, aren't they? Oh boy. There's a ring around the rosy joke here. Oh, I missed those extra rings. Oh no. I think we're going to have to restart this one. Yeah. It's going to be a miracle if we get enough. Huh. The question, though, is will I be able to get... Ugh. I don't think we're going to get 220 rings. Okay, definitely not. Yeah. That's a restart. Just blame Tails on everything. No. And sometimes control your trajectory in midair. A lot better than last time, but will we be able to get enough? Oh, damn. I don't think we're going to do it. Unless we get another big ring section. Nope. I was wrong, apparently. It still gets harder even when you're at this point. Both memorization, and you just gotta sometimes get lucky with how Tails moves. was not a good one. Question from Chefs or Lord Chicken, what's my favorite Mario game? I would say of the classic ones. Ah, damn. While I'm reloading this up, I definitely like Super Mario World. The more recent ones, I think Super Mario Galaxy 2 is my current favorite. There's gonna be a way to. That's not gonna be good. Yeah, you do need to, like, because Tails directly follows you, you have to time yourself to sort of jump before you need to. But the problem, though, is that the jump leaves you out of control longer than just moving. Side, yep. If I remember right, at least I didn't fall for it that time. Wait, I think we just did. Woo! Oh, favorite Sonic? Oh, sorry, I didn't see that. Lord Chicken. I liked Sonic 3 and Knuckles, I think, is my favorite of the classics. I did not like Sonic CD, and when we get to showing that off here, we'll talk more about that. But we still have Sonic 3. Boss time. Now, this is one that you can really try and exploit. At least Tails is useful here, the robotic fights. Well, useful-ish. I know. You lose rings when we're at the end, yeah. Yeah, Tails just will screw you so much in these bonus stages. If you have a second player, at least they provide some backup, but if you play completely solo, then you're kind of screwing yourself even more. Thing is that he reacts quicker when you jump, but then you react slower when you get out of it. Wow. I did not even remember this zone at all. I believe there's one, two... I think there's four zones left in the game. No, no, no. Once we get the last remaining emeralds, life becomes a lot easier for us. And quicker, too, because we won't have to spend so much time in each level. I'm gonna regret this, but... huh? So I keep harping on the quicker you get these emeralds, the just easier life's going to be. Sonic 3, I think, and Knuckles is probably the easiest one to get all the emeralds on, just because there's just so many levels. Not to mention your shields actually get cool powers in that one. Curious what people think about Sonic 3D Blast. I've only played that game, I think, like once in my entire life, and I barely remember it. My god, I hate these damn red springs so much. But as I was saying before, I got a spring scare there. I only played like once. I think that was a rental. Uh-oh. What's happening there? Well, that's like the perfect thing. Oh wait, time to say my least favorite Sonic. I would all the classic ones. It would probably be Sonic CD. But I really haven't given it a fair shot. I think of the modern ones, there's honestly just too many to name. Although I know how horrible Sonic 2006 was. I only played the demo for like 5 minutes, and I knew that there was something horrifically wrong there. Now this is where we need to use the jump. Again, some of these levels just feel a whole lot easier than others. I think it's because they're expecting different skills from you. So if you're better at them than just getting the rings, it just becomes a lot easier. Crap. There we go. Now what? Whoop! I mean, like, this is easy for me. Dope! Unless they just screw the pattern up like that. Something tells me we're not getting it. Nope. Oh yeah, Emerald 7. Can we do it? Here. Let the bouncing begin. Two over here. And back over here. That was almost as perfect as things could have gone, but now... where are you? Oh, there we go. Oh. I have to restart. This could be another one where you're going to need to go grab a drink, folks. Oil ring. I'm pretty sure there's a mountain or a mine one, but it could be this zone too. I know about the oil ring. That I think is one of like the trickiest ones. Alright, so here we go again. The challenge is you need to remember this crazy pattern here each time. So now it's two over here. Two over here. It. Okay, so now this one I have to stay on one side longer. Okay, so I think it's gonna be coming up really soon. Okay, so this is what I think when I just stay on the one side. Three. Four. Alternate. Oh, because I missed that one, wasn't it? I'm honestly tempted to do a second save if we can make it past the second part of this stage. Left. Oh, no. Messed it. And the thing, it screws with you because you keep forgetting what the older pattern is. Alright. Left. Now this is when you get to the double on the left. Over and over again. Okay. Now we're doing any quick alternates. Okay, now. Four over here. Whew! Okay. To make things easier on me, and so you guys don't watch me do this a lot more, I'll make a second save right there. Sorry. Okay, 210. Shouldn't be. Oh, God. Nope. This is only when you need the buffer. Bastard tails. I think we did it. We got it. Woo. And that's all seven. Yeah, I need that celebratory music. Now Sonic can change into Super Sonic. Now things become fun for us. Tails almost screwed us at that last moment, didn't he? So now that I can turn into supersonic, every 50 rings I can do that. Basically makes me invulnerable and increases my speed too. I love that background too with the clouds. That's blast processing, I think, for you folks. I forget if you can touch his belly after you kill him. These SOBs from the first Sonic are back. Yeah, we don't need to worry about that anymore. Is this when the earthquake happens again? Yep. Uh-oh. We went the wrong way. Ooh. Hey. Man, it's really been a long time since I played it, so I don't remember any of this stuff. There. Oh, Tails, you bastard, just screwed me. Tails is the real enemy in this game. If I wanted to make things easier on myself, I probably should have picked him as the main character, just due to his ability to fly. Probably actually get more bounces off now that I think about it. Should be coming to the left. Yep. Shouldn't that have killed him if we blew up his ship when he falls in the lava? Oh, you can only fly in Sonic 3? Okay. And of course, Sonic 3 and Knuckles, you can control Knuckles as well. Mystic, yeah, this is the one I was... I think it's this level, then the oil rig, then I think the ship, and then the death egg. I remember those spikes. There we go. As long as we have rings, we'll stay in supersonic. And the only thing that will kill us are pits and being squashed. Invincible supersonic, I think, is a little redundant. And I remember the music being more epic, I think, in Sonic 3. Ha ha ha, you can't hurt me. Oh. He's going Super Saiyan on us. Don't want to get crushed here. That'll defeat the purpose of Super Sonic. Oh, I think I just broke the game. Oh, that is nice to have Sonic like right there, framed there. Another checkpoint, or another continue. I remember the final boss fight being very tricky. Well, tricky when I was... How old was I when I played this the first time? It came out in 1991. So 6 years, damn. see if we can get another one of those. Ooh, close. I know in Sonic 3, if you get all the emeralds, the whole shebang, you get the extra final fight. Which is pretty cool. Oh crap! Oh no. Well, this is awkward. No, I'm not at 60. I was only 6 when I played it, so. I'm not 60 yet. I know a few people call me, some of the younger people I talk to on my podcast call me an old man, but I'm not that old yet. Gotta watch out for that one part. That additional speed is just really throwing me off. I think it was coming up right here. Uh-oh. There it is. Should be coming to the end, I think. Trying to watch out for any bombless pits once again. Alright, should be at the boss. Can't hit, get hit by those spikes. You can't hurt me, I'm supersonic. Isn't that so much quicker? Yeah, at least I didn't do that this time. Tails, you little... whatever the hell... him go. Oil Ocean. This is one of the trickier ones, if I remember right. Oh no, Tails died. And he's back. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Didn't get the jump in time. Yeah, someone mentioned in chat about staying- oh no! Behind the final boss. Crap. Oh, that's right, we can flow in the oil. And that's probably the best way to deal with him. But again, playing it as a child, I got so frustrated at that fight. I mean, if you're watching this, you can see how much longer this game is compared to the first one. We have to be pushing an hour and a half, maybe close to 2 hours by now. Three more until we hit super. that's perfect. There we go. Now we can just break through. I don't care about your sliding. I'm supersonic. And when you, if you play this as Sonic, I'm sorry, as Knuckles, you just can break a lot of these levels simply by gliding everywhere. What the? Something tells me we're gonna break the game at the rate we're going. Oh no, extra life. We don't follow the basic level. Lord Chicken was leading, but he's back. Uh-oh. I did not mean to do that. Oh no, we're running out of rings. Thankfully, I saw my shield. If it wasn't for getting lost there, we probably could have kept it throughout the whole level. Let me see. While I'm waiting for the level to load up, we're approaching an hour and a half, I think, of actual stream. And we're still not done yet. I have a feeling when we get to Sonic 3 and Knuckles, that may require a double night. Because that is technically two games worth of content when you add both of them up. I have no idea what just happened there. I think we clipped through something. I'm just glad those bonus levels are past us now. Come on, fan, let me through. Tells me I'm gonna need that. Unless we can get the 50 rings. Nope. Oh, tails. Thank you. everyone's balancing. Alright, I think we are definitely coming to the end. Metropolis. Okay, so I think it's this one, then the air one, and then the final space, or the Death 8 one. And then that's it. Ah, yes. I can't wait till I get to the point where I can show off a Dynamite Heady. While it's not a Sonic game, it was another game by Treasure, and it was a lot of fun, and it was also very challenging. Oh! Damn exploding starfish. Oh! And remember what I said earlier about wanting to get those emeralds before we got to, like, these kinds of levels. I mean, look at this stuff. They are not making it easy to preserve your rings. Oh! Am I hyped for the question from Chaz Swirler Chicken? Am I hyped for the new Sonic games? Yeah, I am. I think at this point, it's kind of... I know it's pessimistic, but it's kind of hard for them to, I think, screw it up anymore. And Sonic Generations wasn't too bad of a game. Nope. I would love for them to once again try, like, the Sonic Adventure angle, because I think that was their most successful 3D attempt. Okay, let's go shoot out. Oh, Tails, you screwed me again. And if you didn't play the Sonic All-Stars Racing game, that wasn't that bad of a game either, even though it had nothing to do with platforming whatsoever. I really hope I'm going the right way. Oh god. And these kinds of bounce will eventually, I think, get added into Sonic 3. Oh, oh, oh. I didn't mean to do that, but I'll take it. A little late, though, but nonetheless. In terms of lives, though, I'm in a really great position. I don't think I'll need to save scum to beat the rest of the game. I think we have more than enough lives and continues. And I'll have to see. Wow, that was really lucky. We'll have to see what happens when we get to the end, though. Wow. That wasn't so much reaction time as just dumb luck. And for the folks on Twitch, when we get to Sonic CD, I'll play that Sonic Boom theme. It's one of my, like, guilty pleasure songs I like. I'm just afraid of when I upload the video to YouTube, I'm pretty sure I'll get copyright claim there. I want to go fast here, but at the same time, I know how many bottomless pits there are in this level. Look how his hair goes normal when you look up. The extra speed also just really throws you off, too. But it is nice to be invulnerable to everything. Except for pits, of course. So tough now, are you? Oh, Act 3 has a bottomless pits? Wait, there's an Act 3? No, I don't think there is, but again, it's been a while. I know when we get to the air part, that's just going to be all bombless pits. I'm trying to remember some of these obstacles. It's been so long. Oh, so there's an Act 3 here. Alright, so now this is where things get very tricky. Who do you think would win a battle, Sonic or Mario? The old, age-old question, right? I guess Sonic has the speed, but as we've seen with Smash Brothers, if Mario can grab him or get a hold of him, he's pretty much in trouble. Oh! Oh, I knew that was gonna happen. Fortunately, we're still in it. Oh no. I know those spikes are gonna like shoot out and hit me at like the last second. I'm kind of curious to know, like, how many people actually beat all the Sonic games back in the day, before the age of the internet and such. Is this the part that I remember? No, this isn't it. There's a part where if you go too fast, you fall into a pit while going through those circular tunnels. Oh no. Not you again. What? I got him. Oh, Darkspine Sonic. Oh yeah, there was that game where Sonic became a werehog. I know there was a Sonic game on the GameCube? No, Sonic on the Wii that I heard people say wasn't that bad. I think it was like Sonic Arabian Nights, Sonic Fairy Book, something like that. But I know there was a more modern Sonic game that did okay, I think, in terms of reviews. And of course, the 2D Sonic games on like the GBA and I think 3DS had some favorable reviews as well. Oh, and that will have given us Super Sonic, too. Hmm. crab guy is going to be the bane, I think, of our play. Next behind Tails, of course. Yeah, there's Sonic Lost World, Sonic Colors. I think that's the one that did alright. But that was around the time that I was just so disheartened with modern Sonic games, I just didn't even bother checking them out. Man, this level's big. It's gonna hit. Oh! No, my one ring! I'm waiting for one of those crab things to just like pop out and kill me. Okay. Good thing we got the rings. So I think we grab onto Robotnik's ship. And that takes us into the next zone, or I think Tails flies us out. After this, of course. I don't even remember this fight. Oh god, now I do. Oh god, I didn't want to get killed. Oh, you gotta hit him just right. As long as you have one ring, it's very trivial. I think if you hit him from the bottom, you're safe. Okay, you can time this right. Tails, you did. You actually helped out. What the hell? Tails actually saved the day. It's a miracle. It's gonna snow in July. Okay, so now I think we do the air part, then the death egg, and that's the space area, and we're done. Is this it? Yes. Can I die here? No. Music's so relaxing, isn't it? Take me lower, Tails. Although if I was Super Sonic, we wouldn't really need Tails right now, I guess. This is the part you have to watch out for. This is where Tails can really screw you as well. Oh! Now after this, we get on the ship. Now I think we lose Tails for the rest of the game at that point. Oh! So that's what those guys do. I was wondering what they were actually here for. So I'm probably gonna get a shot off. Nope. So relaxing, isn't it? Oh, you can glitch. It's possible to glitch Tails, maybe? Oh! Here we go. Oh god. This is Bombless Pit Central. Couldn't he just let me off at the pilot area? Tails, you're screwing me again. Don't remember those guys will hurt you or not if you hit them. The turtle bomb. I think we're safe. I feel like someone's about to fly on screen and smack me. Oh, there we go. Now the tough part. No, Tails. Come back. Oh, really? Sir Lord Chicken, did you know Tails' original gender was female? No, I did not. This is one where we really need to take it carefully. It's just very easy to fall off to your doom. Oh, it was a bomb. The gap there. Uh-oh. This could be very bad. Nothing like having enhanced speed in a section where you want to take your time. This is going to be a miracle if we can get through this without getting killed. Oh god. Huh. Alright. I think for this level, we're going to have to avoid getting the 50 rings. I need to move a lot more carefully than having super speed. I am also in. Oh, what's that? Oh. One of those little jump things. There we go. Oh, don't want any more rings. Oh my god, that was horrible! And is where all those lives I got will probably disappear. This, I remember, caused a whole lot of stress back in the day. Oh, of course, now I won't be able to get that. There we go. Hmm. Oh, thank you. I didn't want all my rings anyway. Hmm. I think I'm going the wrong way. Yeah, I gotta be really careful where I'm running. Oh, you bastard. What if I can trick myself again? Huh. That's interesting. Okay. Get me to a checkpoint, thank you. Oh, so that's why Sonic 2 ended with a romantic song. They thought Tails was gonna be a woman at the time. Huh. Interesting. I don't know what the Sonic 2 theme is, because I never had a chance to be as a child, but we will hopefully be able to hear it tonight. Oh, oh, oh! I think there's only one zone here. Like, we'll have to fight Robotnik and then we move on to the finale. We just have to get inside the ship. Once we stay high up and away from the bombless areas will be good. But yeah, we're gonna have to go inside. Is this it? Follow the rings. Oh boy. Oh crap. I'm gonna wait for the platform. What the? Hmm? That was weird. I go the wrong way again? I think I did. Again, gotta be careful not to pick up any more rings. And as I say that, I pick up more rings. Nope. Okay, so... I could actually just ignore those things. Team Chaos or Team Rogues? Let me see here... I think it was Team Chaos at the time. Wait for it. We're doing it! We're doing it! Yes! What the hell? Team Mystic? Oh. What the hell did we miss? Oh. A little teleporter thing there. I'm just so glad we got a bunch of extra lives here. Of course, there was the Sonic, like, attempt at Mario Party on the Dreamcast. It was alright, but it was just super difficult, too, to play. They won't let him hit me just to lower my ring count. Alright, now, where the hell am I going? This is one of those levels that's so nerve-wracking to play. Once we get inside the ship, it's far less stressful. Is this it? There we go. Boss time. Death beam. This reminds me a lot of the boss section from the first Sonic, the double laser trap. But after all that crazy platforming, this is child's play. Of course, now having said that, I'll get killed. Ooh. Let me through. We're going to be needing that. Alright, here we go. And look, Tails is back. Now we're heading towards the real finale. And of course, when this breaks, when we defeat the Death Egg, that sort of sets the stage for Sonic 3. Technically, Sonic should be dead, like, right about now, if we're in outer space. Unless he holds his breath really long. Alright, here we go, Death Egg. In fact, this is a good place for another save, just in case. Ah, yes. Robo, or as we know, a metal sign. Oh! I probably should have just landed on his head there. I think that would have been safer. So I can get two of them in. Uh-oh. I think this is probably just gonna bounce. There we go. Now that, of course, wasn't the real final fight. This is where I'm going to save. This is more for you folks watching, so you won't see me having to replay the Sonic C fight. I'm sorry, Metal Sonic fight over and over again. It'll just be easier for you guys. And easier on me. But here we go. We need to get behind him. The trick is we have to jump when the spikes aren't there. Now he's gonna come down. Oh! I could have actually been on that side. As you can see, each time we die, we have to replay that fight. Which is why it's just quicker to do it this way. Oh, Lord Chicken, you're gonna miss the end, hopefully. The idea is I have to jump when it's either like that. Oh! I knew that was coming. I didn't react quick enough. This is why this part just frustrated the hell out of me as a child. Because you really don't have room for error here. Can I earn my redemption at this game? Again. Yes! Woo! I've been redeemed after 25 years, I guess. Tails is going to rescue his bud. I think that deserves a sip of water. So we didn't have the rings, or I'm sorry, the emeralds. He would basically have to catch Sonic. But once again, we just don't need Tails. I think this calls for some screenshots. Alright, so that was Sonic 2. All the way through as well. Alright, what's our time, anyway? Just under 2 hours. As you can see, a lot more challenging compared to the first one. And if you think this one was long, wait until we do Sonic 3 and... Sonic 3 and Knuckles. That will probably be easily over 2 hours. Possibly, we may need 2 streams to get through that one, but we'll see. After that, I guess we'll move on to, Sonic Pinball, then Sonic 3D Blast, and then finally Sonic CD, and that will sort of wrap up our little Sonic spree there. Sonic Pinball will probably be the quickest, because I think it's only 4 levels, so we may be able to do a double that night. Or at least start it. Let me see. I keep checking the time. I keep forgetting to actually look at what time it is. Yeah. I think we're going to wrap up the stream now as soon as the credits are done. So while the credits are rolling, as always, thanks so much for tuning in. If you've been watching this live, be sure to subscribe to the channel on Twitch. For those of you watching the recording on YouTube, if you enjoy it, be sure to share with your friends. Leave a comment, and of course, like and subscribe to the channel. Everybody, check out game-wisdom.com, where I examine the art and science of games. You can follow me on Twitter at GWBycer. And you can find me on Patreon under Game Wisdom. Any donations would be greatly appreciated. They allow me to keep doing what I'm doing while supporting my household. And if we can hit some goals, it will mean more content for you fine folks. So we'll let the credits finish rolling, and then we will say goodnight. I know we'll never see it, but I still remember Phantasy Star Online. It's like my first real MMO experience. I don't think we'll be seeing that anytime soon. Is there any more end of credits scenes? Nope. Alright. Well, that will do it. So, once again, thanks for watching. Have a great night, folks. And I will see you when we get to Sonic 3 and Knuckles. Most likely very soon. Take care. Oh, there you go. We'll let you enjoy that theme one last time for tonight. Alright, take care.